Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I'm going to be testing some viral TikTok makeup hacks. Now, TikTok is banned in India, but I came across these really viral makeup hacks on Reels or even on YouTube Shorts. I found so many makeup hacks on YouTube Shorts as well. So I thought let's do a fun video where I'm testing all of these hacks. Let's see if it works or not. So before we begin with the video, if you guys still haven't subscribed to my channel yet, then please make sure that you guys hit that red subscribe button, join the family for more beauty, fashion and lifestyle related videos. And now let's get right into the video. So before I start with my makeup, I'm going to be doing a quick skincare regime that I've been following since a while now. So I'm going to be using these two products by Mamaearth. This is the Mamaearth Aqua Glow Face Wash and the Aqua Glow Gel Face Moisturizer. And this is how it looks like. Let's start with the face wash. These two products are a part of their Aqua Glow range and I've been really loving them. So the Aqua Glow Face Wash has Himalayan Thermal Water. It has Hyaluronic Acid and Aloe Vera Gel. All of these ingredients are so good for dry skin. Himalayan Thermal Water is rich in minerals which help fight signs of aging and keep skin healthy. Hyaluronic Acid keeps the skin cells hydrated, which promotes rejuvenated and plump skin. You guys know I have extremely dry skin and these products really help to like restore that hydration on the skin. Especially the face wash, it does not strip all the oils from my face. It is super hydrating. You guys know all Mamaearth products are free from all toxins and harmful chemicals. Next, I'm using the Mamaearth Aqua Glow Gel Face Moisturizer, which gives up to 72 hours of hydration, and this is how it looks like. I absolutely love the packaging. It is so like heavy and luxurious, and also the texture of the product. This screams hydration to me. So again, this moisturizer contains Himalayan Thermal Water, Hyaluronic Acid and Aloe Vera in it. It gives up to 72 hours of hydration. It is a lightweight gel formula. It feels super lightweight on the skin. You don't even have to like reapply it throughout the day. Also, it's one of those moisturizers which makes your skin really plump and glowy. Both of these products are available on Mamaearth's website, Nykaa, and also Amazon. Also, you guys can use my coupon code RYNA2021 to avail a 20% discount on these products. Every time you buy from them, they link your order on the website to a tree that they plant. The exact geolocation and the picture and the species of the plant that they're planting will be sent to you. Isn't that a really, really great thing? You guys know that Mamaearth is a plastic positive Indian brand. So that's something that I really love about it. Now let's get started with testing the hacks. So first I'm just gonna prime my face regularly. I don't have like a priming hack. So I'm just gonna prime my face. So I'm going to be linking all of the original like hacks videos that I saw, and I'm going to be linking them in the description box below. But for a few hacks, I just know them because I've been seeing them since a while now, but I don't have like a proper video. For the foundation hack, you must have seen this, that once you dot your foundation on your face, you just have to spritz your setting spray and then blend your foundation in. Apparently, it'll give you nice coverage and it'll make your base very, very long lasting. So I want to try that today. So I'm just taking one pump of foundation on the back of my hand and I'm dotting this on my face. I'm honestly really scared to do this because I just don't want to mess with my base. I don't want to remove everything and then do it again. But we're just gonna do it. While this is still wet on my face, I'm quickly gonna blend my foundation. So this is how my base looks like. Honestly, it just blended perfectly. I don't know why I was so scared to try this hack earlier, but I had no issues with blending my foundation. But I don't know how long lasting my base is gonna be. For that, I'll really have to check that out. So I have a long shoot day today. I'll either do like a check-in or I'll just let you know on the screen if the hack really worked or not. But my foundation blended really smoothly. I had absolutely no issues. I do feel that the setting spray made my base a little bit more tacky. Like I feel that tightening and that tacky feeling on my face, which is honestly not bad. It means that my foundation will last longer. So my dark circles are completely covered. Now we're gonna try the face lifting hack with a concealer. I've tried this before, spoiler alert, I've tried it and it is actually really good, but I haven't tried it with like a very light concealer. I tried it with a concealer which was just one or two shades lighter than my skin tone. So I don't know if it really worked that much, but today I have a concealer which is like 4 or 5 shades lighter than my skin tone. And this is again not a new viral hack, but it is something that a lot of people love and are actually using on a day-to-day basis. Just gonna apply this in the inner corners of my eyes, over here. Let's blend this one side and see what difference it makes. This is how the lifted side looks like. Do you guys see a difference? I don't see a huge difference when it comes to lifting. Yeah, but there is a little bit of difference. Yes, there is definitely a little bit of difference. I'll quickly do the other half of my face and set the concealer using a loose powder. I will give a thumbs up to this hack because even though it looks a little gray around my mouth, I really like it under the eyes. I think it really brightened my face and it did do a good job of lifting it up as well. Now let's try a blush hack. Now I've seen this video where the person is applying the blush right here on the apples of the cheek, and on the other side she has just applied the blush over here, like on the cheekbone, and her face looked really really lifted from one side. And I really wanted to try it because all this while I've just been applying my blush on the apples of my cheeks, so I really think I should change that. So to try that, I'm gonna be using a liquid blush today. I'm not gonna directly apply the blush on my face. I'm just gonna warm it up on the back of my hand. Then using my beauty blender, I'm just gonna apply it over here on my cheekbone and also my temples. Okay, I'm already loving this blush hack. It definitely a thumbs up. I really like this blush technique. It makes my face look really really lifted. Now let's try a contouring technique. So I literally just yesterday saw this hack where you just have to keep your makeup brush, like the bottom of your makeup brush, over here, and then you can just apply your contouring powder and you're done. So I think this hack is really cool and I really want to try it. So I'm gonna be using a compact powder in the darkest shade. I'm gonna be using this fluffy brush. Just taking a little bit of product first because I don't want things to get really messy and muddy. I think I should use a thinner brush. Nope. Yeah, I'm gonna be using this brush. It actually worked. Do you guys see the shadow over here of the contour? I am really loving my nose contour today. This is I think the first time that I've done a proper nose contour, and that too so easily. Now to balance everything, I'm obviously gonna contour the rest of my face as well. I'm gonna be doing an eyebrow hack. I'm gonna be taping all the edges of my eyebrows and then I'll be using an eyeshadow to fill it in. Let's see if it works or not. I honestly think it'll look very different and weird because I never really fill my eyebrows properly. Like, I like them very bushy and I like that undone look for my eyebrows, so I never really do a proper Instagram brow routine. I'm so sure that this tape is gonna ruin my makeup today. I'm just gonna stick the sellotape first on my skin so that it's not extremely sticky and not painful while I take it off. it took me forever to achieve this. This is so, so time consuming. Now I'll be using a dark brown eyeshadow. I've seen people using black, but I'm honestly a little scared to use black on my eyebrows. So I'm just applying this on the edge of my eyebrows. I think it's gonna look good. Now I'm gonna remove this tape and paste it over here. And I'm applying less product over here so that it looks a little bit natural. I can sense it that my eyebrows are gonna look very thick. My eyebrows look so hilarious. Firstly, they're completely uneven, and also this tape thing didn't really work that well. Oh my god, it looks so fake and so bad. I'm just gonna wipe everything off. Definitely giving this hack a thumbs down, because firstly, it is very time consuming. It works if you do it very, very perfectly and precisely, and I'm pretty sure that no one has that kind of time. So this definitely gets a thumbs down. Now I'm quickly gonna fix my eyebrows and be right back. I'm back looking like a human again, and now moving on to the next hack. It's an eyeliner hack. I'm pretty sure that you guys have seen this hack either on reels or on shorts. I think it'll work, but again, it involves taping and everything, which is something that at this point I'm hating, but I'm still gonna try it. How do people breathe while doing this? I literally cannot breathe. This is how it looks like. I cannot even lift my eyelid completely, and I cannot even breathe. I will be using the same dark brown eyeshadow, and I'm using my beauty blender to apply this. I can see that it works. Let's see. Whoa. This wing is a little bit droopy, but it actually worked. And why will it not work? It took so much effort to do all of this. I think these hacks work, but it's really hard to judge how thick and how thin you want your eyeliner to be, because I was not really going for this thick eyeliner look, but it still happened. I think both the taping hacks were completely useless. Why do you have to take the tape all the way from here? You can just apply a tape here, and you can get a proper wing just like that. Or I could just spend 15 minutes doing my eyeliner and making it even rather than doing all of this. I'm just gonna try and fix my eyeliner, and then we're gonna do the last lipstick hack. I was just gonna do one last hack, but I suddenly remembered this one mascara hack that I recently saw on Instagram, and I really want to try that. So the hack was that you take your mascara wand, and with the edge, you just coat the edge of your lashes like this, and then you go in from the roots to the tips. Again, I'm gonna coat the tips of my lashes. And then from the roots to the tips. Okay, this is one hack that I really like. I think it helps you to separate your lashes really well, and it makes them look very prominent because you're coating the tip of your lashes. So I really like it. It makes my lashes look so thick, which never really happens. Like, it looks different from what I usually do. So I really like this hack. I definitely give it a thumbs up. So I came across this lipstick hack where you just have to pucker your lips. You have to line your lips and then fill it with a liquid lipstick. And then when you like release your lips, it looks very plump. And that's like a hack for overlining your lips. So we're gonna try that. Thank you. Oh my god, I don't think I've ever overlined my lips so perfectly. This hack genuinely worked and I had no hopes from this hack. But it looks nice. The lip color is not something that I like a lot. I just mixed it with a darker lip color and I think it looks very nice now. My lips genuinely look so plump. I'm definitely gonna do this more often. I am surely impressed by this hack. Definitely a thumbs up for this hack. And with that, we come to an end of this video. It's surprising that most of the hacks actually worked. Only two hacks didn't work. But other than that, I'm really surprised by all of the other hacks. So with that, we come to an end of this video. I hope you guys enjoyed watching the video. Please don't forget to hit that like button, subscribe to my channel, hit the bell icon besides it to get notified whenever I upload a new video. And I will see you guys in my next video. Bye!